Well, I'm at a, what is it, a Flying J? Yeah, I'm out here in Virginia. What place is this? Oh, I forgot. I'm by the Virginia, West Virginia border, and got this wonderful fiasco going on, which is looks like a trainee. He's learning how to back up into what you call it, into the oh geez, I can't talk. I'm like preoccupied. Anyways, he's trying to back into trying to back into a parking spot. He's got his trainer out there. But it doesn't seem like this person is really getting the hang of the backing. I don't know if he's not really taking too much or taking the direction of the trainer. But I've been sitting there watching for a little bit, and he's just having the hardest time trying to get in to that little spot where he almost hit that white truck that's right there. But the truck that was in the other spot on the other side of the Walmart truck, he just left, I guess, to go find another parking space so that this truck can have more room to get in. But I should have taped this earlier, because he was setting himself up all wrong. He was setting himself up all wrong to back in, where I guess he was trying to do a 90 degree back, but still couldn't do the 90 degree back because his truck was arcing too much to where he could not, make that kind of a turn in this area. At least the way that he was set up, it wouldn't have worked. He was trying to back into that spot, being perpendicular to the spot. And typically the easiest way to get into these spots is by setting yourself up to where the truck is, or where the trailer is at a 45 degree angle to the line of trucks that you're trying to back up to, with the truck actually, I don't know how many degrees it is, probably 120 degrees there. Your truck will be angled with the trailer about 120 degrees. That way, when you get ready to back in, all you gotta do is just crank those wheels to the right. You're already set up to where that you can, you know, you're already set up to have the truck already, or the trailer already back into the hole. But when you crank those wheels to the right, you just got that much more turning power there, I would say. And that would help you get the back end of your trailer all, you know, all squared up into the parking stall. And that's how you typically would do that out here. But yeah, he was having a really hard time, and he had his trainer out there. I guess it was his trainer, either his trainer or it was just somebody just helping this guy out. But that's good though. If this guy was just being helped out by a passerby, well then that's pretty good. I mean, compared to other people who will sit here and videotape and sit there and laugh at a person because they're messing up, or they're not getting the hang of the backup or whatever. They're sitting there waiting for them to mess up. That's what they're doing. So I just happened to see this just a little while ago. I didn't know exactly what was going on until later, when I grabbed the camera. But anyways, he's finally in there now. And so,
yep. Just remember, now.
Now, this guy in front of me, he typically did, although he was, although he started way out on the other side of the row of trucks, which is giving him not that much room on the right side of his truck. The way to approach it is you come alongside the trucks that are on this side of the line, and then you arc out to a 45 degree angle where the back end of your trailer is pointing into the parking stall. And it looks like that dude was just helping out fellow trucker, which is good. So yeah, now see, he's having to crank that in there at a 90 degree angle just about. But if he had to run alongside the trucks on this side and then flared out to a 45 degree angle, he would have relatively gotten that truck in there, the truck and trailer in there, relatively easy. Maybe had to do one or two backs, but would have got it in there. So, that's backing for you.